Hey guys, welcome to another video. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about a sneaky little indicator on how you can actually identify, or rather how you can profit from traders who are losing money. Okay, so this strategy was taught to me by one of the, the directors of a brokerage. Okay, so it's a very potent strategy. Okay. So you definitely want to stay to the end to make sure that you apply this so-called indicator correctly. Okay, so now before I go into this indicator over here called current ratio, okay, I just want to say some disclaimer. Okay, in the previous video that I just recorded, right, like yesterday, okay, I say that indicators are not meant to be used to generate trading signals. Okay, it's only meant to give you an idea about what to do. Okay, or kind of as a confirmation, meaning that you already have your bias, you already know what you want to do, right? You analyze the market structure, then you look at indicators, okay? But for this indicator, it's kind of like, it just points you in the direction of what currency pairs you want to look and what strategies you want to adopt, okay? I will go into more details about how to use this, but I just want to make a disclaimer that you never ever, just use this current ratio and just start, buying or selling based on this current ratio immediately. Okay, that's not something you want to be doing. Okay, so let's get into this current ratio. Okay, so I've typed in Google FX SSI current ratio. Okay, so there are many different websites providing this current ratio, but for the sake of this video, I just want to start off by talking about just this one. Okay, I want to just give you one website to have a look at. Okay, if you are new to this current ratio, then just stick to this for now. Okay, so just Google this and you click in. Okay, so let me just explain to you what the current ratio is and why it's so powerful. Okay, why the broker, the director of the brokerage actually told me to use this. Okay, so now what you're looking over here is that you're looking at the different you can see over here that you have different currency pairs, right? So for example, I'm on euro dollar right now. Okay, so you can see groupings or brokerages. Okay, so just switch over to the brokerage. Okay, so how do you see this? Okay, how you see this that for euro dollar, for euro dollar, the people who are trading on InstaFX, right, a brokerage, 51% of them are long and 48.3% of them are short. Okay, so you have all these brokers here. Okay, these are some of the bigger brokerages. Okay, just a disclaimer, right? They don't cover every single brokerages. Okay, it's impossible to get data of every single brokerages, but you just kind of just want to get a sense of, idea of how people are actually trading. Okay, so if you go over to the pairs, you can see different pairs. Okay, they don't have everything, but they do have some of the more common pairs. Okay, so how you want to read this is you want to come down over to here, the average. Okay, so how do you trade this? Okay, not how do you trade this? You don't trade off directly, but how do you use this as a, kind of like an indicator to tell you what currencies you might want to be looking at? Okay, one way you can do it is you can look it at you can look at the average. Okay, so as you know, most retail traders lose money. Okay, that's a fact. Okay, so doesn't it make sense that if most people are buying euro dollar, right, and most people are wrong, most people lose money, then you want to be selling instead? Okay, so I repeat myself. Okay, most traders lose money. Okay, so if you see that a large percentage of traders are buying euro dollar, then you want to go the opposite, you want to sell. Okay, so that's the essence of using this current ratio. Okay, so in this case over here, you can see that a euro dollar, it's 41% buying, 58.93% selling. So it's kind of a neutral. Okay, so this kind of scenario, right, you don't really have a clear direction. Okay, so how do you use this? One way to do it is that if you know that roughly half of the traders are buying and half of the traders are selling, right, then you kind of expect it to be a range bound. Okay, so if you know that the price is likely to be range bound and you see a breakout in euro dollar, okay, you can look for a fake out setup. Okay, fake out means that price closes below the support or closes above the resistance, and then after that, you know, it just totally reverses and goes back into the range. That's the essence of fake out. This is how you use it if you see that the you know, the buy and the sell, it's pretty you know, seem like they are quite it's a tough fight, meaning it's like 50-50. So in this case, it's almost 50-50. Okay, let's look at another currency pair. Let me find a more obvious one. So, okay, in this case, we don't really have a very obvious one. Okay, maybe probably something like this. Okay, it's not the best because the buying is 60% and the selling is 39%. Okay, ideally, you want to see something like a 80-20. Okay, so if you see that 80% of the traders are buying USD franc, right, and 20% are selling, that means that most people are buying. In this case, you want to look for selling opportunities, okay? It just kind of gives you a hint that you want to go to the charts, right? Look at the charts and look to see whether you can find any, you know, bearish setup, okay? And I repeat, you do not just, you know, based on this and start selling dollar franc, okay? That's not what you want to do. And that's not what I'm saying over here. What I'm saying is that you want to use this as a reference, okay? So earlier on, I said that most traders lose money, correct? So you are basically trying to profit off the mistakes, or rather their lack of, you know, profitability. Right? You see that they are losing money, you're just trying to use that info to your advantage. Okay, so you can see over here that there is a Saxo. Saxo is a brokerage. Okay, all these are brokerage. But let me just show you an example. This is Saxo. Okay, Saxo Capital Markets. So what I did is I just did a Google, right? Saxo percentage of traders who lose money. You can see over here that as part of the, you know, like regulatory requirements, brokerages must disclose how many percent of their traders lose money. So you can see over here that 72% of retail investor account lose money when trading CFDs with this provider. Okay, so this is back to my what I said earlier on, that most traders lose money, okay? So because they are losing money, that means they get the direction wrong, right? They are trading in the wrong direction. So you want to do the opposite of what most traders do, okay? You do the opposite of them, and then you probably have a higher chance of winning money from the market, okay? So if you were to do that for, you know, all other brokerages, you will find the statistics or so, but you don't need to do that, right? I'm just trying to explain to you that how you can use this current ratio, okay? Current ratio to find out what kind of currency pairs you should be trading at this moment, okay? The other one that is also very useful, it's actually the Forex Factory also. Forex Factory also have a area like this. Over here, you can see. Over here, you can see this is the same concept, euro dollar, pound dollar. But this one, I don't like it so much because it has lesser currency pair, and it's kind of, you don't really know which brokerage they are referring to, okay? But this is also somewhere that you can go. You go into Forex Factory and you click trades, okay? So now, before I end off this video, I just want to, maybe I just want to show you a, let me see if I can just show you some idea about how to use a how to use this in real time. Okay, I think that would be helpful to you, right? To show you exactly how I use it in real time. Okay, so please take note that this is not foolproof. As I said, it is just an indicator. Okay, so for example, now you see we were saying that for example, let's look at okay, let's say dollar yen. Okay, so dollar yen right now, most people are buying, and most people lesser percentage of traders are actually selling. Okay, as I said, just a disclaimer, this is not the best setup, but that's what we have at this moment, because you see that all the currencies are roughly about in the center except for dollar yen and dollar CAD. Okay, so for the sake of this example, let's just assume that you know, dollar yen, the majority of traders are in dollar yen. Okay, so if you switch to dollar yen, right, you will see that most traders are buying and they are probably losing money now. Okay, so if based on this indicator, you say, okay, I understand that most traders are buying dollar yen, so I want to sell because most traders get it wrong. So this is how I profit off their mistakes, correct? So you look at it and you find a setup, okay? Here's the key. You want to find a setup, a trigger, an entry point to short into dollar yen, okay? You do not just, you know, blindly close your eyes, right? Pray and then start shorting it. No, you need to have a plan. Okay, if you need a plan, I have ton of videos in my YouTube channel teaching you different strategies, okay, because different people have different personality. So I share with you all the forms of strategy that my team use, right, because we have different traders in my team and each of us is different, okay. So you can check out the videos, okay. In fact, I have a day trading guide down in the description also. So that day trading guide will give you a step-by-step system on how to trade. Okay, that's for day trading. Okay, hopefully that works for you. But if that doesn't work for you, then you want to check out my other videos. Okay, but I want to reiterate one last time. Okay, you go over here to get the idea that I should be focusing on dollar yen. Okay, you get the idea here first. Then you come here to look for the short opportunity. If the market is still very bullish, then you do not want to short into the bullish market. Okay, you still want to follow your trading plan. Follow your trading strategy, right? But use this as a reference, okay? So right now, actually, it's 1st May. We just sent out a signal in our Telegram channel to short CAD yen. And this is also one of the reasons why, let me just clear it, why we shorted CAD yen, because we see that, you know, over here, you don't have a CAD yen, okay? You only have dollar yen, but we see that most traders are buying dollar yen, means they are selling yen. Okay, so that's why we went the opposite direction. Okay, this is just one of the things that you know, we use as well. Okay, but it's not the only thing we use. Okay, so if any questions about how to use all this, right, you are new, okay, please leave a comment below. If this is the first time you're watching our videos, right, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Okay, we record a lot of videos like this, okay, videos that, you know, that we paid a lot of money to learn, you know, like all these kind of strategies, this kind of insider tips, right? You can't find it off, you know, websites like babypips.com or, you know, trading, you know, TradingView. You can't find it anywhere else because all these are things which we paid money, okay? We paid people who are really good at their craft to teach us, right? Some of them, they don't even charge because they don't even have a course, right? They just, you know, because of the good working relationship we have with them. For example, like this current ratio, right? Because of the good working relationship we have with them, right? They teach that to us, you know, they just like secretly tell us, hey, look, this is one thing that you might want to consider. You know, it's been very effective for us. You know, this is the kind of information that our channel over here brings to you, okay? Information that you cannot find elsewhere, okay? If you go watch other YouTube videos, you will not find information like this, okay? No one's going to share with you this kind of insights. But for us, I think we want to be different. We understand the struggles of a new trader, especially if you do not have the money to learn strategies like this, okay? You do not have the money or do not have connections, okay? Fortunately, you have our videos. So make sure you watch this video. Make sure you subscribe. Okay, if you have any questions, just leave the comment below. Okay, thanks for your time. I'll see you in the next video.